Hello and welcome back to my channel. This is Hera Yankee 1, Echo Bravo Echo from Greece, and I want to thank you all for supporting my channel so far. If you like my videos, please subscribe to the channel and press like. It's a big help and it keeps me going. So today we have another radio, another handheld radio to show. This one is from Wouxun, or Wouxun. I think the correct pronunciation is Wouxun. It came to me after a contact I had with the company. They sent me this radio to showcase. Because I'm in Europe, they used their sub-brand name, evote. So this radio, although it's a Wouxun radio, in the box it writes evote, as you can see on the screen, but it's the same as the Wouxun model that sells internationally. So first of all, let's see what was in the box. Inside we had two antennas, the classic rubber duckies, I guess. This one is a bit harder, this one is a flexible one. Okay, the charger with the base for the radio. And this is the radio. Okay, they must have sent me a production model because it's unbranded, as you can see. Normally it writes Wouxun up here, or evote. I have already inserted the battery. It's a 3000 milliampere battery, quite big. I left this in the box. It's the protector for the 2-pin plug that I have removed from here because the radio is waterproof. I removed these two screws here to take this protector out so I could program the radio and put some microphone on also. Let me take the box out and let's see a few things about the radio. So first impressions, we have a quite sturdy radio here. It's big, nice fit in the hand, waterproof. Here is the Kenwood plug connector, and down here we have USB-C port used for charging, not for programming the radio, but charging the battery, besides the charging base that it was sent with the radio. Plus one for this. I'm going to keep saying that in every video I make when I see a USB-C charger. Okay, side buttons here, PTT1, PTT2, and two more buttons under the PTT. And let's see how this works. I'll just put an antenna on. Okay, before I proceed, let's see the characteristics of the radio a bit. As you can see here on the side of the screen, transmission, it's 6 meters, 1.25 meters, 2 meters and 70 centimeters, so it's a 4-band radio, and reception to all these. Airband, of course, AM, FM radio, the 4 bands that we saw upstairs, and also 714 to 999 MHz. Other interesting things that I saw that make this radio jump out from the mass are here. As I said before, 3000 milliampere battery, 999 channels, it's a 5-watt radio, okay, pretty standard for handhelds. It has dual reception, double PTT, scrambler, programmable side keys, we'll see them later. And here's the really interesting fact for me, a real crossband repeater. This means that this radio has two transceivers inside, that they work at the same time. Most radios, especially the cheaper ones, have one transceiver, and what they do to have dual reception is that they oscillate between the two channels that you have chosen. So they go back and forth, trying to determine if a VFO is transmitting in one of those channels. But when we have a real crossband repeat radio, it means that it has two transceivers inside that they work at the same time, independently. I hope we'll see a demonstration later on. Okay, let's power this radio on and see how it works. Right, before I proceed, up here we have the classic rotating on-off button, volume, and a rotary encoder. It's 2-in-1 that helps changing, as you can see, settings on the selected band below. As you can see, I have activated dual reception here. This can be changed easily by pressing this button, the TDR. Okay, it's this button right here, and right now we are in single mode. Down here, when I press this, it writes the model of the radio, the ATQ332, which is the same as the Wouxun KG-Q332, which sells internationally. So let's see a bit the functions of the radio. In its position, up and down, we have a sub-menu system that changes the parameters of the specific VFO. Let me activate the second one too. Right now the upper one is active. This is why it's in bigger letters, and we can change between the two VFOs by pressing the band button right here. Right now we are in down. In order to go to the sub menu for this VFO and its settings, we press the green button once, and here we have some settings specific to this VFO that is active at the moment. There's step, commander, scrambler, call code, okay, that's the TMF, scan mode, scan group, scan add, tone scan, the CTCSS, mute mode, this is if it will receive a CTCSS tone, and open. This is channels, name, add, delete. If there's a shift, the offset. This is the display, if it displays a name or the frequency or DCS, receive CTSS, busy lookout, wide narrow, TX power. Now here let's see what options do we have. I thought there were three options, low, medium and high, but in the radio there are four options. There's medium, low, and there's an option ultra high. Now I haven't found anything online or in the manual about this ultra high power mode, but I will check it because I'm expecting a power meter in the following days. So I will test some of my radios and see what power output they produce, and we'll see also this ultra high setting. Okay, squelch, and we're back to step. Right, so the same thing happens if we go to the upper band. Again, we press, there's the sub menu for this band with all those settings. Now the main menu of the radio is again with the green button, but you have to long press it. There we go. Here are the options that are common for all the radio. So we have battery save, Roger, timeout timer, Vox, voice if you want to hear it. That's timeout timer alert, so it alerts you when the timeout is close. Scan mode. And here we have a few options about the side keys. You can define what they do. Another very interesting feature in this radio. For instance, the top key is this one up here. I won't press it at the moment because it will start the alarm function. Okay, as you can see, I can choose between source and alarm. And then we have PF1 button defined, which is this one up here. It's the second PTT. Right now it's set as PTT. I will show you later how it works. PF2, this one under the normal PTT. As you can see, short and long press. And again, PF3, the button down here, short and long press. Power on message, side tones, auto lock, primary channel and primary channel scan. Here's a repeater function. We have two options here, the direct repeater and the two-way repeater. Repeater speaker and PTT, the alert tone, brightness of the screen on active and standby, FM radio, and here are themes. The DC mode, as it says, is a display mode actually. Right now I have activated the black one theme, which I like the most from the ones I found in here, but if I go to check another one, the one that the radio comes from the factory, it reboots, and this is the white theme, but I have to say that I prefer the black one. Okay, perfect. So this is the menu. It's most of the items here are classic in handheld radios. Some of them not, but you get the point. Okay, let's see a bit the menu options more extensively, at least some of them. The top key, as I said before, this one up here that activates the alarm and the SOS function. So this top button, if I press it once, it activates the flashlight, the LED, which is quite strong, I have to say, stronger than usual. If I long press it, which I'm not going to do right now, if it's in alarm mode, it activates a local alarm here on the radio, and intermittently it opens the PTT, so maybe I can call for help or something like that on the channel that is active. If I have it in SOS function, it doesn't open the PTT for me to talk or to be heard, but it transmits all the time the alarm tone. Let's see what else do we have. Okay, the PF1, which is the second PTT button, which is up here. This is something you have to get used to it in this radio. The normal PTT button is this one, and the secondary is this one up here, which makes sense because it's easier for your hand to have the main PTT here and the secondary up here. You have to want to press it. The secondary PTT button here can be adjusted, and it has two options, call and VFTX key. How those work? If it is on call mode, if I press it now, it will transmit the DTMF call code that is programmed in this channel. As you can see here, I have another radio here open, and it transmitted the DTMF code. Now, if I change this to VFTX key, it acts like the secondary PTT button normally, but it activates the secondary VFO. So not the main one, but the one that is down here, or the other way around. See here, it will activate the PMR16 right now, right? And if the bands are changed, it will activate the upper one, which is PMR11. So it's simple. This is the main PTT key. This always activates the secondary VFO. Okay, other options. PF2 short and long. Let's see what options are for those buttons that are programmable, those two down here. Okay, you can open the FM radio, the squelch, so you can monitor, CTS scan, DCS scan, backlight, scan the channels or the VFO, monitor. Those are the options, and of course you can disable it. And they also are available in the PF3, which is the button down here, the last one. So as you can see, you can customize those two as you like, and this one up here also, to give it the function that you prefer. I personally leave it on the double PTT because sometimes I have to transmit on the secondary VFO. Another thing I want to mention about this radio, because it's not one of the cheap ones, it doesn't cost $25 or euros or 40 or 30. It costs about 180 euros and $190. I mean, it's another category of radios, of course, but this shows immediately because the electronics in here are far better and the quality is far better from other radios that I have handled. And you can very easily see that. Of course, as I said, I'm expecting a power meter to test some of my radios for the power output. But another thing I always check is how good they behave with an external antenna. These radios are not made for external antennas, for the big antennas, which is pretty normal, of course. They are handheld radios that should have small antennas like this, like the Diamond 771 or the Signal Stick. Although, if you have visited the Signal Stick website, you will see that some radios, exactly because the Signal Stick is a very good antenna, it receives a lot of strong signals, some radios, cheap Chinese radios, can't cope with that and they overload so that you can't hear anything. So this is one test that you can do and check the electronics and the filtering of your radio, is to connect it to an external antenna and see how it behaves. Not to transmit, but just to see how it receives. Let me connect it to my external antenna here, which is not a fancy one, it's just a dipole I made, but it's outside in the balcony. It's big enough for me to transmit and receive. Okay. Right, now, if I put a frequency here, I always use a frequency that transmits all the time, and some airband frequencies are good for this because they have open frequencies that transmit all the time in order to give information to the airplanes. So it's easy for us to test things without having someone to call us. Okay, I'm gonna put this frequency here. Right, so this is Athens Volmet. It's meteorological data that are transmitted all the time for aircraft use. As you can see, as soon as I connected the antenna, it started receiving, no problem there. I have to say that in cheaper Chinese radios I receive nothing, absolutely nothing, because they're overloaded from the signals around and they can't receive anything. Of course we have some noise here, the signal is not very clear, but you have to understand that the antenna is not tuned for this frequency. I just wanted to show the filtering system and the quality inside the radio. Okay, let's close that one now, and we can go back to the memory channels by using again the DTR button here in the middle. This changes the mode in each VFO. Now we went to channel memory mode, but without the names that we have passed from the programming in the PC. This is again the channel memory mode, but it displays the frequency instead of the name of the channels that I have programmed. And if I press it once more, we have the names that I have stored in the radio. So this frequency up here is PMR 11. I'll change the one down to PMR 16. And here we are again. No. Now, the repeater function, the crossband repeater that I talked about. Let's see it in the menu for just a second. I pass it. Oh, here it is. Okay, so we have two modes here. This is the one-way repeater and the other one is the two-way crossband repeater. The one-way repeater works as its name says, one-way. So you transmit from another radio. This radio in the one frequency receives the signal and transmits it to the other frequency you have set here, one-way. The two-way repeater works both ways. So someone can answer to you through the crossband repeater. You transmit from one frequency, this radio retransmits it to the other frequency that is programmed. The third party hears your message and responds, and the radio here does the opposite job, transmitting again the newly received signal from the third party back to you. Let's do a quick test for this.
A few moments later.
Okay, I've set up two radios here just to check the repeat function that the Wouxun KG-Q332 does, or the evote ET-Q332 does, depending from where you buy it. As I said before, this is a crossband repeater, which means that the frequencies that you must choose have to be in different bands. So I have chosen the PMR band and the VHF band just to make a quick test of this function. I'm sure I won't disturb anyone. Here in the Wouxun, I have chosen a frequency that I have set in the VHF band, and in the upper VFO, I have PMR 11. And here in the Quanzhenk, I have set both VFOs to PMR 11, so we won't have any confusion. What will happen is that in a third radio that I have, I will transmit in the VHF frequency, and this radio will retransmit what I say to PMR 11 channel, and the Quanzhenk will receive it. Let's see how this works.
Test 1, 2, 3, test 1, 2, 3.
Okay, so that worked perfectly. The transmission passed from the Wouxun radio and was transmitted to PMR 11 channel. Now, if I do the opposite, but I won't be able to talk so you can hear me. If I transmit the PMR 11 frequency, the Wouxun will receive it and transmit it in the VHF band. And this is how a true crossband repeater works. Okay, that's all for now. There will be a part 2 of this radio to show the CPS and the programming and some things that I stumbled upon while trying to program it from the CPS that Wouxun gives for PC use. Thank you very much for watching the video. If you liked it, press like. You can comment below asking questions or anything else. And of course, if you want to support the channel, please subscribe. See you next time.